This movement has swept through every major city in the UK. Hundreds of thousands have been in protest against this country's deep racial inequalities. For weeks, they've been knocking on the door of Downing Street, and today, the government answered.
I can't ignore the strength of their feeling. And we have to look at discrimination in the education system, in health, in the criminal justice system. We have to look at all ways in which it affects black and minority ethnic groups. And so we're going to have a big effort, which we'll be announcing very shortly, a new cross-governmental commission to look at what is going on for black and minority ethnic groups.
If you missed that, Boris Johnson will be ordering a cross-government commission to understand racial inequality in the UK, but has not announced just what the fuller scope will be, who will be part of it, or why it is needed, when they already have over 40 years of recommendations that have not all been fulfilled.
But the point is here we have a Prime Minister who is commissioning yet another review into racial inequalities in the backdrop of so many reviews, we can barely count them, but hundreds of recommendations which are not only telling us what the racial inequalities are, what the evidence are, but they're also giving us a plan of action. And this government has clearly ignored that.
This was Brixton 1981. The Lord Scarman report into this disorder found that racial inequalities in policing and opportunity were a big factor, and at risk of being an endemic disease that could not be solved. Almost 20 years later, the racist murder of Stephen Lawrence created another landmark moment. The McPherson report into police mishandling of the case found that the Metropolitan Police was institutionally racist. Like the Scarman report, it set out a number of key recommendations. In recent years, there have been even more reports and even more promises from Boris Johnson's predecessors.
That means fighting against the burning injustice that if you're born poor, you will die on average 9 years earlier than others. If you're black, you're treated more harshly by the criminal justice system than if you're white.
This man remains the chair of the race disparity audit that Theresa May launched. I mean, when you see kind of today's announcement and the kind of wave of protest that we've seen, do you feel like that's a sign that the work of the audit has failed?
Well, the work of the audit, particularly ethnicity, facts and data, has been growing and hasn't stopped. And that's been really brilliant. And now I hope with this commission, at least, it is focused on solutions rather than more data and more information.
When you think kind of post-McPherson, all of the reports that have come and all the recommendations that have been created, how many of these have actually been implemented to date, especially even in the last few years?
You know the answer. It's frustratingly slow. All these reports and none of the recommendations fully embraced. Even the Stephen Lawrence reports have never been fully embraced, as a matter of fact. And that's over 20 years ago.
In Parliament earlier was a reminder that today's announcement has arrived amidst pressure.
The Prime Minister has announced yet another review. But what we need is not another review, but action on the recommendations of the many other reviews which have already reported.
The Prime Minister rightly has announced that he is establishing a new cross-government commission, and that will, again, rightly so, Mr. Deputy Speaker, build upon many of the recommendations and the work that has taken place.
In recent years, the government has seen the Angelini report into racial disparities in deaths in custody, the Lammy review into racial disparities in the criminal justice system, and the McGregor-Smith report into racial inequality in the workplace. Now what many are demanding is action.
Personal trainer Patrick Hutchinson and fellow Black Lives Matter protesters carrying on an injured white counter-demonstrator to safety during violent clashes in London on Saturday. He spoke to Channel 4 News exclusively yesterday, playing down being labelled a hero. Today we spoke again to Patrick and to his friends who were with him at the demonstration, and I started by asking him what real action to improve policing here in the United Kingdom would actually look like.
Definitely, obviously, first and foremost, to have a lot more people of colour in the police force. That obviously needs to change. But not just in the police force, we need them higher up. Not just, you know, on the beat, we need them higher up in positions of power within the police force that can, you know, ultimately make real proper change. And as well as that, we do need also the police to have more of a sympathetic attitude towards the public, because what does happen is that you can be black and go into the police force, but then you can become part of that problem, part of the institutionalised racism.
I guess you were all around when Stephen Lawrence was murdered. I was a reporter at that time, and I'm wondering, do you think police prejudice has eased since then, or that really nothing really has improved on policing?
They haven't improved at all. They haven't improved at all. Everything needs to be looked at from top level all the way down to the grassroots.
The difference now is because of social media and the technology that we have, a lot of things that used to go on behind closed doors are now at the forefront, and everybody can see everybody else's true colours.
Jermaine, you believe it's not just the police who have to change, but the whole of society really needs to change. How would we move to a situation in which society woke up to equality and the need to sort of understand other ethnicities and races?
I feel that it needs to start from... Everyone needs to start probably re-educating themselves. You know, we need to educate our young. We need to make sure that they've got a system where they know they can build a future, not looking ahead and knowing there's nothing except for maybe the job centre, if you're lucky. You know, there have to be opportunities for everyone on every side. Every kid who wakes up and says, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a lawyer, I want to be a police officer, I want to be a barrister, they should have that opportunity.
Do you think that this could be just the very beginnings of a turning point, or it'll just be another of those blips in history when people think, oh, there might be change, and then there isn't?
Well, I hope so. I hope this is just a step, even if it's just a little step, for closer to equality, then I hope this is it, you know? Because there needs to be some change, and I hope this is the time now, you know, and things just don't go back to the way things are.
Pierre, I mean, what do you want politicians to do at a time like this?
What I want the politician to do is exactly what us five of us did on Saturday. We stepped up. We didn't just talk about it. We went out there and we'd done what we had to do. So right now, I'm calling for Mr. Boris Johnson to invest back into our community, give us some funding so we could look after these kids, which you can see they're running wild. Now, I want to re-educate my children. I've got three sons, we've all got children here, and it's just getting crazy. All of you can see that. What are you doing about it? I've stepped up with nothing in my pocket, empty pocket, all of us here, and we went out there to make sure that nobody lose their life. Not just black kids, not just white kids, not just Chinese man or whatever. People breathing, living, crying. So, Mr. Boris Johnson, I'm asking you, I'm telling you, I'm not, because we've had enough of begging and every minute knocking on the door. I'm telling you to step up, just like we did, and do something about it.
Has he stepped up when he says he's going to have this big commission to try and see what can be done?
All I'm hearing is review, review, review of what? Look at what's happening. Look at the children. It's a mess. Put something in place so everyone needs to be re-educated. The hooligans need to be educated. They're bringing up their children to believe that it's okay to be racist. It's okay. It's not okay. And the kids that are the black kids, they're growing up thinking that, oh, we're second best, so it's okay for us to be thugs. And no, it's not okay. It's not. I'm serious. We've had enough of begging every minute. I'm telling Mr. Johnson to come and help us look after our children. And that's what he needs to do.
And, Jermaine, if we're looking for symbols of what's happened in these last few days and weeks, do you care much about statues being removed?
You know what? A statue's a statue. The statue can't pay my bill. A statue cannot give me mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. A statue can't educate me if it's not symboled correctly, all right? So, you know, to me, there's more to what's going on right now than removing any form of statue right now. We need hands-on in the parliament, and we need hands-on in the community.
Patrick, what do you think the legacy of these times might be. Is there just a chance there will be change?
I'm hoping that the legacy will be some real genuine change for the future, real genuine equality for all our children and grandchildren, my nieces and nephews. I'm just hoping that they, you know, don't have to go through what we've gone through and what my parents went through and what my grandparents and great-grandparents went through. You know, hopefully this could be the catalyst to really push some real genuine change, real equality across the board for everybody.